In this video, you will learn what JQL is, how to access JQL searches, and basic structure of JQL. Let's take a look at what JQL is. JQL is a text-based language that defines how Jira narrows down a search. JQL looks like this. You can search for complicated criteria that can't be defined with a quick or basic search. All JQL queries do two things. They select a subset of issues and order the results. JQL queries support complex searches to help you find issue data across multiple fields in multiple projects. Okay, now let's have a look at how to access JQL searches. There are two ways to access JQL searches. The first is by using the search field. Select Search from the main navigation bar. Then Advanced Issue Search. This takes you to a list of issues. To see the advanced search in JQL, select Switch to JQL. At the top of the screen is an editable text box. This is where you'll write your custom query in JQL. A query is the statement you use to run a search. The second way to access JQL searches is to go to the main navigation bar and select Filters. Then, select Advanced Issue Search. This brings you to the same page as before. This text is the JQL query that Jira has written for us automatically. The query result shows us issues created in the last 30 days, ordered by their created date in descending order. You can create your own complex searches using JQL in this text box. But first, you need to learn the language. The easiest way to see how JQL is written is by moving from basic search to an advanced search. Change to basic search. Now, select a project from the project filter. Update the status filter by selecting In Progress. Then select Switch to JQL. The search results haven't changed, but you can see the query in JQL. Let's take a closer look at a Jira query. This entire statement is called a query. A query is made up of multiple clauses. These clauses define the issues you're searching for. Each clause is made up of multiple elements. Let's run through them. Each clause has a field. In this example, the field is project. The field is then followed by an operator. In this example, the operator is the equals sign. The operator is then followed by a value. In this example, the value is Lima. In order to complete your Jira query, you must connect each of your clauses with keywords, such as and order by. Let's go back to our query from earlier and apply this new knowledge. Here's the first clause. Just like our example, in this clause, the field is project. The operator is the equals sign. And the value is Lima. The keyword and allows us to connect this clause with another. Let's break this one down too. This clause's field is status. Its operator is the equals sign. And the value is in progress. This query tells Jira to show issues in the Lima project that have a status of in progress, and to order these issues by their created date in descending order. To recap, a query is the statement you've used to run a search. A query is made up of clauses. Each of these clauses are made up of fields, joined by operators, and then values within that field. Multiple clauses are then joined together with keywords. To use JQL effectively, you need to understand how these parts of the query work together to provide search results.